All right, we're going to need to do a couple more definitions. This notion of a version space turns out to be really important in understanding how to analyze these algorithms. So imagine we've got some hypothesis space H, capital H, and a true hypothesis that we're trying to learn, C of H. This is also sometimes called a concept. And we're trying to learn from a training set, S, which is a subset of the possible inputs. And what our training set consists of is those examples along with the true class for all of those X's. So at any given time, a learner might have some candidate hypothesis, little h in big H, and a learner that produces a candidate hypothesis, little h, such that C of X is equal to H of X for all X in the training set is called a consistent learner, right? So what would be another way of describing what a consistent learner is?
A consistent learner can actually learn the hypothesis or the true concept.
Well, it produces, right. I mean, of all the possible things it could return, it returns the one that matches the data that it's seen so far.
Right. So it's consistent with the data. That makes sense.
Yeah. And the version space is essentially the space of all the hypotheses that are like that, that are consistent with the data. So we'll say the version space for a given set of data S is going to be the set of hypotheses that are in the hypothesis set such that they're consistent with respect to the samples that they're given.
Okay, that makes sense.
All right, good. So I think what we'll do next is a quiz just to make sure that we kind of get this concept and how it works. And we'll do that next time.
Okay, sure. I like quizzes.